Hello, welcome to FitTut. I'm Dr. Nandita Shah and I'm the founder of Sharan. And Sharan helps people prevent and reverse diseases. We help people reach their highest health potential. And today's topic is, why no dairy? Why does Sharan recommend no dairy? Now, that's a real difficult one to get because, you know, ever since we're young, we've been told that we need milk. And milk is the best food. But let's think about it. In nature, every mammal produces milk only for their young. And no animal drinks another animal's milk, right? You don't see goats drinking pig's milk or monkeys drinking elephant's milk. We are the only species that drinks another animal's milk. Now, what's wrong with that? You know, we feel that it's something good, and that's only because our mothers ran around us with a glass of milk when we were young. And why would they do this if we didn't need it, right? But actually, we have been manipulated by an industry that wants to sell. The dairy industry, the meat industry. I often tell people that if you want to know what to eat and what not to eat, make a list of everything that's been advertised and don't eat that. Because nobody needs to be told what we need to consume. It's in our instincts. Like if you are on a farm or an orchard and you see fruits and vegetables, you instinctively feel like picking and eating them. Isn't it true? But every baby loves their mother's milk. They don't want to leave it. But when you first give them cow's milk, do they appreciate? No. That's why mothers put sugar and cocoa in every glass of milk and then run around for half an hour in order to force it down the throats of their children. But milk is very addictive. And as we grow, we become accustomed to it and then we don't want to leave it. We love our milk and curds and buttermilk and cheese and paneer and ice cream and ghee, right? We even believe that it's good for us. Now think about it. We often think that it's good for us because if you're a vegetarian, where will you get your protein from if not milk, right? So let's think about it. Where does a cow get her protein from? Every single cell has protein. And greens are abundantly full of protein. And so are beans and seeds and grains. And since we're eating all of these things, we don't need milk for our protein. In fact, we have to think, what does milk have that actually harms us? Have you ever thought about that? You know, milk is the secretion of a female mammal, and so it contains all kinds of hormones naturally. Estrogens and progesterones and growth hormones and oxytocin and prolactin. And you know, our body is in a delicate hormonal balance. And if we put in more hormones, then we end up getting hormonal diseases like we are today. Today we have so many hormonal diseases. Hypothyroid and hyperthyroidism, and then diabetes because insulin is a hormone, and lack of vitamin D. Vitamin D is also a hormone. And then infertility and menstrual problems and breast cancer and prostate cancer and prostate enlargement. These are all hormonal problems. And the major cause of these hormonal problems are hormones from outside, the hormones that we get from dairy or meat. And so we can actually prevent and reverse all these diseases by thinking about what we put into our mouths. Imagine, we don't need to take medicines all our lives. So that's one reason. Then milk contains, you know, milk has the perfect nutrition for a baby calf. Baby calf grows to full size in 18 months. And so it needs a lot of growth hormones. But when it comes to us, it makes us grow. Protein is the food for growth, but then grow. And that's why we have a huge obesity epidemic these days. Right? Then the other thing is that, you know, a cow's udders are meant for a calf. When we try to take this milk quickly with our human hands or with milk machines, those udders are invariably injured, indurated, and inflamed. And in order to control the inflammation, cows have to be given antibiotics in their food every single day. Imagine that. That means that the antibiotics, and you know, 80% of the antibiotics produced in the world are fed to animals in our food chain. That means that all these antibiotics that are fed to cows come back to us through the milk. And that's why there's a huge problem of antibiotic resistance. But despite all these antibiotics, do you know that because of that inflammation and induration, which is then every cow's udders because of the way we are taking the milk from them, because of that, there's pus in the milk. Actually, there are regulations about how much pus is allowed in the milk, but nobody looks at them because there's way more pus in every glass of milk. Actually, you know, if you want to smell it, when you put milk in the refrigerator, and then after some time you open the refrigerator and smell, it has the smell of pus. You can actually smell it in your refrigerator. So pus and antibiotics and hormones, these are just some of the bad things in milk. You know, if you see your the cows, they're often eating in the garbage dumps, aren't they? Now what's in the garbage dumps? Plastics and organic waste in the plastics, because we don't have enough food to feed our billions. How will we feed the cows? And so, and then we put all our organic waste into a plastic bag and throw it in the dump. Now these poor cows who don't have anything to eat, they eat the organic waste with the plastic bag because they are unable to open the plastic bag. And then this results in plastic in their stomach, which stays for a long time and ends up as PCBs in the milk. And there's a fabulous film called The Plastic Cow, which you can catch on YouTube, which talks about how much PCBs there are in milk. So these are just some of the reasons why we don't want to have milk, because it's harmful in so many ways. But now think about a few other things. You know, when we consume milk, I mean, every mammal produces milk only for their young. And if we consume milk, then somebody's not getting their share of milk. And that's the calf. Did you know that cows are artificially inseminated when they're just 2 years old so that they will have a pregnancy, so that they'll deliver and they'll produce milk? And then sometimes even the first milk, the colostrum, is sold as a delicacy. That means that the calf hasn't had even a drop of milk, not even the first milk of its mother. Now, how does that feel to you? Does it feel right to deprive any baby of its mother's milk? But that's what we're doing with every single glass of milk. I mean, many of us are vegetarian because we don't want to harm animals. But with every glass of milk, we are harming animals because the male calves go to slaughter to make veal and calf leather. And the female calves are tied up away from their mothers so that all their mother's milk can be sold. Isn't that awful? Now, you might be thinking, okay, if we don't have milk, where do we get the calcium? And that's another lie that we've been sold, because where does a cow get the calcium from? Calcium is a mineral. It's found in the soil. Everything that grows in the soil is full of calcium. Did you know that sesame has 10 times the amount of calcium that is there in cow's milk? You can get all your calcium needs from greens and beans and seeds and grains. In fact, if you just eat things which cows eat, only plants, you can get all your calcium needs. So now, let's think about what do we do if we don't have milk? What will we have instead? And you know, instead of milk, now there are so many alternatives. That means soya milk and oat milk and almond milk and cashew milk and peanut milk and rice milk. And you know, the simplest milk is banana milk. It's as nutritious, if not more. And all you need to do is peel two bananas, put them in the blender with a little bit of water, blend it. You have a fabulous white liquid, which is even sweetened, so you don't need to add sugar. And if you want to make it more delicious, you can even add some fruit to it, some other fruit, and make it a mango milkshake or a chiku milkshake or something else. Isn't that amazing and so simple to make and so inexpensive too? And then there are other milks as well. In fact, coconut milk can be had instead. But you know, the reality is that we don't even need milk. Why? Because we're not babies, right? Milk is a food only for infants. And if we're not infants, we don't need milk. And so you can do without milk, but having milk causes problems. I don't want to end before telling you that even Ayurveda says that milk is mucus forming. Milk actually causes respiratory diseases like asthma and sinusitis and colds and coughs. And I stopped consuming dairy in 1980 because I realized how harmful milk was to both the calf and to human beings. And I haven't had coughs and colds almost ever since then. So it's really worth a try, and especially right now during the COVID-19 pandemic, because COVID-19 affects the lungs and we are more prone to having lung problems if we are consuming dairy. So think about it, stop dairy, very important right now, and get healthy now. For more, I just want to say one more thing, that when I say milk, milk means milk, cheese, buttercream, paneer, ice cream, curds, buttermilk, and ghee, but you will not be deprived. We have fabulous recipes on our website, sharan-india.org, and you can find replacements for paneer or cheese or dahi or anything that you like before, including mithais. Imagine if you can have your cake and eat it too, why not? Wish you the very best in health. Thank you.